As I thread through the people thronging Washington Square, the white Triumphal Arch looms. Approaching it, I drink with a rush the vista framed by its high stone, Fifth Avenue, running up the centre of the city, dead straight like a spine. I steer around the arch and up the vista, which fans to take me, reconverges after me, and elongates ahead. Walls and windows tower either side, angles yawning downward to slide me up between them. If I glance left or right, a street unfolds to take my glance. Dangerously ascendant, I can hear the zeros singing for me. Horns blare, engines pound, and tyres grind sharp into black tar. Visuals and music for my march towards a building whose approach I can feel. A helicopter's clatter, like a jagged scratch on velvet, cuts the sky. I feel my clothes against my body, and a drip of sweat trickle down the centre of my back. The GE building soars up ahead, and then around me as I push through its doors. Everyone inside is like a clockwork toy from a museum cabinet, gesticulating jerkily behind the dusty glass that seals them off from the obvious thunder's roar of what is coming, what has pulled me, what the destined meeting is whose thudding spreads already through the walls and through the city's groan to grimy wire fence city limits and beyond. How come all these people hear so little? Okay then, stepping lightly on the sheen of stone, in rhythm with a thud, never hurrying, I pad through the lobby, under cameras, to a bank of lifts. An open lift door comes in frame. I enter, push the close doors button, hear a ting through the thud, and press the very highest button. The panelled wooden doors close. The lift moves and gathers speed, hissing up the shaft of the tower like a piston. The heartbeat on the soundtrack grows in volume. Scarlet numbers flash. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, to a few unnumbered floors at the top. The lift glides smoothly to a halt. The doors open, I step out, the thudding ends.